Shibava so Shepherd
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
Father, in the name of Jesus, and most high God, thank you. I bless you, I worship you, I magnify your name. Thank you, Father, for yet another day. Thank you, Father, for we are privileged to gather before you this hour. Father, many that are better than us in everything, they slept, they are no more now. Father, you gave us this opportunity for us to see another day, to think about our yesterday, that we may not make the same mistake again today. For us, oh God, to reconcile with you. For us, oh God, to amend our ways. Jesus, we are grateful, we are thankful. All glory, all honor, all adoration belong to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Almighty Father, amen. We are to hear from you. Speak to me. Speak to me. My mouth is your hands. My ears belong to you. Use them to your glory, to the end that we all can be blessed this morning, maximally, in Jesus Christ's mighty name. I expel the devil and all his agents, every demon connecting right now, be disconnected by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Every mad wandering spirit, I bind it now. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. This morning, please, every other person, meet your mic, I said, Brother Nis. Every person, please, meet your mic, I said, Brother Nis. This morning, we have a message titled, Calling and Waiting on God. Calling and Waiting on God. Two in one. And I was made to understand that majority of people know how to call on God. And they don't know how to wait on Him. Most of us are calling on God, shouting, we need God's blessing, but when it comes to the point of waiting, we miss there. Sometimes the Lord might tell you, wait on me in the area of singing. And before the Lord come and meet that you're no more there, you're not in the area of evangelism, you have missed it. Sometimes the Lord, after praying, okay, I want to wait for me in so time. In 2 months time, I will visit you. In a month time, I will visit you. In a week time, I will visit you. And before the Lord come, if you start calling another thing, you will miss it. So what do? We have to learn to call God and to wait on Him. The Bible tells us in Romans chapter 10, verse 13. In Romans 10, 13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever, the ticket is for everybody at this point. Whosoever that will genuinely call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Well, how can you be saved when you don't wait on somebody you are calling on? Hey, Apostle Manny, please come and rescue me from so. I am coming now. And before I get there, you are run out of there. How can I save you? So therefore, the Bible told us here in Psalm 27, verse 14. Psalm 27, verse 14. Wait on the Lord after you have called on Him for rescue. after you have called on him for to come and bless you. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. Be courageous. Trust on him that you have called upon. If you have called upon God, wait on him. Wait on the Lord. And be of good courage. And he shall strengthen the heart. Wait. I say on the Lord. You have been able to call on him. So wait on him till he come. Don't be in haste. Don't be rushing. Wait on the Lord. He will strengthen you. I say again, wait on the Lord. The Bible told us in Acts chapter 2, verse 21. Acts 2:21. And it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Again, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So, but what do you do? As you are praying for God to give you the grace to pray, to ask, also pray that God give you the grace to wait after praying. Then it says in Psalm 130 verse 5, Psalm 130 verse 5, it says, I wait for the Lord. I don't know about you. I wait for the Lord. My soul doth wait, and his word do I hope. After I've called on him, in the cave Adullam, after I've called on him, as I was running from my soul that is pursuing me, I wait to him, because I know surely he will come. He's not a man. He has heard me. I will hope on his word. I will depend on his word. I will not be hasty. I will settle down and wait till my help comes from him. What do you do? Are you a busybody person? You are calling today. Before tomorrow, you are made up your mind again to call on somebody else. As you are calling, you are planning, you are thinking of plan B. It can never work. We must learn to balance the equation. Calling and waiting. I wait for the Lord. My soul doth wait. And in his word, do I hope? Where is your hope? Is it on any man? You will fail. After you have prayed, make sure you hold on to the word of God. Keep digging. Keep studying the word of God. And at the appointed time, it will come to you. Psalm 91 verse 5. He shall call upon me. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. It is certain. If you can call, he can answer. He will call upon me. She will call upon me. They will call upon me. And I will answer him, answer her, and answer them. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. But the point is, allow him to meet you where he has placed you. Allow him to meet you at that doorpost, at that place of agreement. I will meet you at social time, at social place. Be there. Remain there. It's where patience is very, 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 very important, imperative for every Christian. The Bible told us in Micah 7:7. Therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. He is my safety. He is my everything. He is my shoulder buckler. I will wait on him. I will rest my case on him. No matter what is happening around me, I know surely my Redeemer will come. Our Redeemer is coming. Our Rewarder is coming. Now that we are fasting, let us learn to fast, pray, and wait. Wait on your time. Don't be prognosing on other people's own. Rejoice with other people, but don't try to get theirs. Wait on your own. Everyone have it's our whole portion in God. Wait on your own and wait on your time. Your time will surely come. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Therefore, I wait. I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the Lord, for God, of my salvation. If you truly know that God is your safety, wait on Him. No matter the time, wait on Him. And I know it will not delay. It will come in Jesus' name. Amen. Psalm 145:18. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait. Not busy, but daily wait. Not prognosing in things you don't know. As you are waiting, the devil is watching you. The enemies are watching you. You must be careful to make sure you maintain your lane. Stay on your jurisdiction. Stay on your lane. Stay in your consequency. S, if you dash out of your lane and enter another person's lane, and that is the place for your angel to come, or for the Lord to come, and he meets you in another person's lane, you will extend your own waiting period for another 7 years again, or another 7 weeks again, or another 7 days again. That's why you see some people's time in wilderness will be elongating. They elongate their time by themselves. Why? Because of busybody. And I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
He says, the Lord is near unto all them that call upon Him. To all that call upon Him in truth. Psalm 148:18. I mentioned it before. Psalm 148:18. The Lord is near unto all them that call upon Him. To all that call upon Him in truth. How are you calling on Him? Are you calling on Him in truth? We remember where we started from. In Romans 10:13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now he's telling you, it's not just by calling. You must call on Him in truth. You must be truthful. You must be real. You must not be a chameleon. You must not be an hypocrite. Let God see your sincerity. The Lord is near unto all that call upon Him. Okay? To all that call upon Him in truth. Are you calling upon Him in truth? Or you are calling Him and your mind is in TB Joshua. Your mind is in 180 Joshua. It can never work. You are not sincere to yourself. You are not sincere to what you need. We must learn to balance ourselves in the Lord. Be truthful. Run away from sin. Run away from iniquity. And I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So we are ready for Lamentation 3:26. Lamentation 3:26. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. As you are hoping, be quiet. Don't keep quiet. Let your spirit be quiet. Remember where He placed you. I remember when Brother went to heaven, and the angel of God said, stay here. I will come again. Or rather, the Lord said, stay here. I will come here again tomorrow to meet you here. He brought some house. Hey, look at flower. Hey, I'll walk away from there. He would have walked away from there and enter here. He was there. See, the Lord come the next day. Had the Lord placed you in the area of singing? Because the one that is doing introduction, they always call him. You have run away from singing now and enter there. And God has sent you, this my daughter is singing for me. You are left there. Maybe you are reading the Bible. Okay, and they always call the other one. Okay, I will go and jump into the Bible now. When the blessing of those who are reading the Bible come, they will look for you, they will not see you. Everything in God's house have principle. Whatever you are doing, hold on to it. Okay, God, I want to be singing for you. I want to be reading the Bible. I want to be doing this. Okay, my daughter, my son said, she will be reading the Bible. She will be singing. She will be doing this. It is written for you. And make sure when somebody is doing it, you are not filled with jealousy. Hey, they call this one. They praise this one. They don't praise me. Wait until your time comes to call you again. Let us learn to follow God in the Spirit. Whatever you are doing, do it in the Spirit. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Wait and hope for Him quietly. For your salvation is near. Job chapter 14, verse 14. Job 14, verse 14. If a man die, shall he live again? No. If a man die, shall he live again? No. All the days of my appointed time will I wait till my change come. Wait on the Lord till your change come. As he knows that you are waiting for, he will preserve you. He will never allow anything to happen because he knows if you are waiting on him, you have no plan B. He will never allow evil to befall you. So they that wait, that trust on the Lord, wait upon him alone. They that choose to be called of God, wait on him alone and stay in your position. Maintain your lane. Stay in your duty post and quietly stay there because your time, is your appointed time of change is coming. Everyone has his own appointed time. Don't jump into another person's time because it wouldn't work. I pray the Lord grant us understanding of his word in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. First Corinthians verse 8. 1 Corinthians 16:8, it says, give thanks unto the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the people. This is where it lies. As you are waiting, do everything to make sure you praise him. Even when it has not come, praise him in advance. And what Esther was telling me yesterday, he said, I don't know the day now. I was praising God. I was thanking God. The person before me was saying, what is this one praising God for? You cannot see it. But after the praise, rain fell. After the giving thanks, rain fell. She's always most time on the street doing whatever she knows how to do. Today, the Lord is blessing her. So what do you do? Whatever God has placed your hands to do, do it quietly. And let us showcase his name. Let people see Christ in you. Wherever you go, go in his glory. Run away from sin. Give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. Psalm 105:1. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deed among the people. The same thing, Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Call upon me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty thing which thou knowest not. Call on him, and wait till the voice comes. The voice is coming. The revelation of transform you is coming. The revelation and the direction that will transform you is coming. Call on him and wait on him. Never plan for plan B. Psalm 25, verse 5. Lead me in the truth Now teach me, for thou art the God of my salvation. On thee do I wait all the day. All the day. How long have you been waiting? You have fed up already. I can't wait anymore. This man said, all the day of my life will I wait on the Lord. We must be ready to wait till our change come. And our change certainly will come. Wait. Don't be too in haste. Don't be a busybody. Relax. I know the God we serve. It's the God that answers prayer. At the appointed time, that his name will be glorified. He will come. So there is a seat. Everything is upside down. Don't worry. Hey, our brother is dead. Christ is not coming again. He will come. He knows when to glorify himself in your life. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This last one. Hebrews 10:22. Let us draw near with a true heart. This is where it lies. Let us draw near unto the Lord with a true heart. Purge your heart from every excess. Purge your heart from everything that the Lord wouldn't want to meet there. Because you know why? Because that is the place is coming. That is the powerhouse of a man that the Lord wants to come and minister to. Purge everything. There's none of God in that heart. Let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith. Have faith in him. Trust him that he's able and more than able to do what you are calling him to come and do. Having our heart sprinkled from an evil conscience. Make sure your conscience is clean. Whenever your man look at somebody, thank God, I have nothing against that person. Hey, Stephanie Anthony, God, I thank you. Hey, Brazil is, thank you, Lord. Hey, Sister Caroline, Jesus, thank you. Anyone your heart goes to, you are always joyful. You have nothing against anybody. Your heart is pure. No matter what the devil do, he can never utterly bring you down. You know why? Because you are always connected to the powers of God. Your heart is clean. Children of God, at this time of our waiting on the Lord and calling on the Lord, let's do everything humanly, spiritually possible to make sure our heart is pure. Our hands is clean. Hold no grudges against anybody. Hold no guilt against anybody. Don't jealous anyone. Don't envy anyone. Be pure. Wherever problems come, quickly cut it off. Satan will want to make sure he give you problem. As you see it, quickly do everything to cut it off. And learn to mind your business at this time. Learn to stay on your lane at this time. Learn how to seal your mouth at this time. Learn to add the Holy Ghost. Lock my mouth and hold the key by yourself. My leg, be careful. Don't take me to where God will not go. So that even the little one you have, they will not take it away from you there. Let us be careful. Our conscience must be clean. And our bodies washed with pure water. Ask the Lord to wash you pure with his hyssop. And make sure everything about all this time around must be clean. Our words must be seasoned. Our dressing must be decent. I'm not saying go and buy big clothes. No. Make sure you are not wearing what God will say and go back from you. Let us be careful. Calling and waiting on God. And I pray the Lord will help me, help you, help every one of us to learn to call him and the grace to be patient and be doing, stay in our duty post, be given to us today in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Are you out there? You are not born again. You are waiting and wasting. If you are not born again, you are calling on God and waiting upon Him. You are calling for problem and you are wasting away. You are not waiting, but wasting away. Give your life to Christ today now before it's too late. Say after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard the word. I'm happy the way you speak to your children. I want to be a part of them. But right now, I'm in a far country of sin and iniquity. Father, I am ready to come out of it now. Have mercy upon me. Wash me clean with your blood. Purge me. I renounce and denounce the devil and all his works. I accept the Lord Jesus Christ today as my Lord and personal Savior. Come into my life. Come and dwell in me. From today henceforth, I receive the power from you to go and sin no more. The power to call on you and to wait on you and to trust in you. Father, you are now my Lord and personal Savior. I am born again today. All things have passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for saving my soul. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for giving me ear to hear and the heart to do. Thank you, Almighty God, for giving me the grace to be alive today, that I may hear your word and repent of my sin. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Have you declared this generation? I and the saints in the house, we are all rejoicing right now. The Lord Jesus Christ himself is rejoicing, and the holy angels are rejoicing because of you. And I pray this salvation that brought joy to us today, that brought joy to heaven, will never bring shame again tomorrow in the name of Jesus Christ. The grace, the strength, everything you ever needed to run this race to the end, receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ. The grace to maintain your lane, to stay in your lane, receive it now in the name of Jesus Christ. Every sort of busybody, I come and kiss out of your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Amen. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Father, I thank you, Lord. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. Father, you have used me again to speak your word. Father, I'm not speaking from heaven. I'm on earth here with your children. Help me to be the doer of the word I've just spoken. This word will not be used against me, nor against any of your children on this mountain. Father, in any way I've spoken of God wrongly, have mercy upon me. And let your blessing rest upon us all in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless by this word. Unmute your mic and shout hallelujah.